And that's what we need the Department of Justice to understand, that like, we're not in normal times. It doesn't go back to normal when you let somebody do this. You know, he molested democracy. Okay, you need to go in there and kick some ass. It doesn't have to be all the charges, but it has to be some charges, because a bully only stops when you sort of metaphorically punch him in the face. And he needs to know there's pushback. And instead, they see weakness, essentially. Democrats don't want to hear that, but Republicans are not scared. They're having rallies every weekend, right? They're having fundraisers. Neil Gorsuch is speaking at the Federalist Society at Disney World with no press allowed, right? The guy who's supposed to be impartial, you know, which is also where Trump's case will probably end up, right? In the Supreme Court. So at least you can start the legal process of holding this guy accountable instead of being silent, because Benny Thompson said that we're thinking like May or late April for hearings. Well, May or late April for hearings, if you got people that don't show up and defy subpoenas on the hearings, that means if justice moves on those people, it's another 6 or 7 months before they go to trial. Steve Bannon defied his subpoena in November, and his trial begins in July. So you start doing the math, because the election's in next November, right? The midterms are this November, right? 11 months, whatever, 10 months from now. You see what I'm saying, Jimmy? You don't have that much time, and democracy doesn't have that much time, because in the meantime, all these chaos agents are hard at work, and all these rallies are happening. And it's these rallies where these plans get solidified.